And fuck you, Blade Boy. Kick him, boy. Rip.
Yo, what is going on, you guys? So, on the last chapter of Bayonetta, apparently some creep is ironing on Bayonetta for some reason, maybe connected to Bayonetta's past, or maybe a future boss, we don't really know. We haven't really seen him, but we did hear him. Like I said, very creepy. As we enter the city of Vigrid, we find out this place has more connected ties to Bayonetta's past, as we did a bit of pole dancing, kicking ass on the dance floor. We also found out that some of old Bayonetta's old comrades got snacked on by whatever this angel-like beast is that took a while to take down, and Bayonetta tries to recover her memories. And it would seem that Vigrid has some ties, or at least triggered some memories of Bayonetta. So why that is, we don't know, but I'm excited to find out. Which brings us to now, and we're about to begin Chapter 2 of Bayonetta and Vigrid, City of Deja Vu. So like I said, I can't wait to see how things play out.
Fancy bumping into you here. Out to find some answers about your past, are we? You've quite the familiar face, and using the same powers, but you'll have to forgive me. Do we know each other? Same powers? Don't make me laugh. Your little dip in that lake has left you a bit rusty. Oh. I've been high and dry for 20 years now. The only rust on me is from the lack of any real challenge. Perhaps you're up for the task. You've already disappointed me. Is a moment I've long desired. But you've forgotten your destiny and wasted the past 20 years. You're right. I do seem to be having trouble remembering things of late. Would you be so kind as to take it from the top? Two overseers, the eyes of the world. They are the power behind everything.
John, as heir to the clan, the time has come for you to prove your right to fight under the Umbran name. You may select opponents of your choice.
Then allow me to face the outcast.
None! Helene Kiadagat! The child is of impure blood. Challenging her would be a violation of our tenets of faith.
It would not be the first time we faced each other.
Coward!
Will you face me in this hallowed arena?
Well, if I must.
But I pray you've got a little something for me in return. You know, I'm very fond of stuffed animals.
Alright, here we go. Oh boy. Nice. There we go. Weave. Oh, okay. So we got the both wall climbing. Like Naruto. Naruto and Sasuke confirmed. Sun and Moon confirmed. Here we go. Got you now. Oh, we boom. Man, that was hot. And we got a gold. Okay, so as Bayonetta seemingly gets a power boost, it looks like we get some juicy, and I mean juicy and hot lore involving Jean and Bayonetta. So they've had recent battles in the past, so that was kind of interesting to find out. So this chapter starts off very hot and very heavy very quickly with some important answers to a lot of important questions. So I'm glad they started off this way. Now Jean mentions the two overseers in the eyes of the world, but what's interesting, this Bayonetta says they have the same powers. Jean is making it claim that they're not on the same level, but I find it very interesting they have this similar type of grace and elegance to him. And I also get the feeling that Bayonetta is being tested here, testing Bayonetta, considering she's like rusty from losing her memories. Bayonetta, and finally, Bayonetta recognizes who Jean is. All right, so it seems like we can wall climb. Cool. Time for a bit of target practice. There we go. Whoa, there you go. There we go, pole dancing. Boom! What a way to finish off your opponent. No damage. Sweet. Here we go. Oh, so the moon allows it to wall climb. That's cool. Yeah. There we go.
Us here together, and it will never tear us apart.
Damn it! I said stop! I'm authorized to use deadly force! Fuck! Where'd that bugger go?
Sayonara. Fleur de cirée, eau de parfum. Such a wonderful floral bouquet. With its subtle hints of rosemary. You know, in the language of flowers, rosemary equates to remembrance. Which doesn't quite equate to you, now does it? Bayonetta! Shit! Will you stop that?
That little bug on Enzo was a nice touch. Seeing you here, I suppose it wasn't the only one. You've certainly bloomed, haven't you, my little Cheshire Puss?
I'm not your pet. The name is Luca. A name you better remember. Shit! Damn it! Wait! You can't just run away from me like that! I know what I saw that day! About your kind. Sure, my colleagues laugh at me for chasing fairy tales, amongst other things. But I know they're real. I know the truth. The smell. It's the same smell that clung to the air the day my father was murdered. Which means I'm right on your doorstep, Bayonetta!
I'll let you in on a little secret, Cheshire.
The name is Luke!
You need to hone your sense of smell, my dear.
There's no rosemary in the perfume. After all, rosemary is a demon repellent.
Here we go. Whoa! I'm the weave master. Let's get it.
Thank you.
Boom! You. There we go. There we go. Bye bye. Oh yeah, totally kicking ass now. Hello. Holy, what? Oh, that's the most OP bow and arrow I've ever seen. There we go. That's that.
You only run away so fast because you've got something to run from. Me! But you can't escape me forever.
Oh. Somehow we phased through that instead of jumping over. All right. And we got a Beyblade. The Enchanted Beyblade Angel. All right. Well, in that case, time to let it rip. As in, time to rip these Beyblades a new engine gear. See, I know my stuff. Okay, looks like we're not going that way, so... Oh! You tell him, Bayna, get out of here. Whoa. Man, fuck your Playboy. Whoa. Uh-oh. You about to summon your buddy? A big buddy, too. But I can use the axe. Alright. So that's how it is. Take you out first! Get out the fucking way! Gotcha, bitch. Who's the destroyer now, bitch? Big mistake. For that, I'm gonna fucking kill you. On your knees, bitch. Where you belong. Chow time. Oh my gosh. Seek him, boy. There you go. How you like that? Mmm. Tastes good, don't it? The taste of pain and the taste of love. Any more health before I go out? Get enough butterflies. Butterflies for days. Sayonara. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the way she attacks with the limbs reminds me of Nico Robin. Which ain't a bad thing. I mean, that's one hell of a duo, I will say that. Finally. Got Platinum 2. Game. Okay. Alright, let's get as close as we can. There we go. Come on! Fucking move it. You know what's crazy? This might be the furthest I've come. I'm not too sure about that, but... I do remember it took me a while forever to do that. Oh, goody, a church. So nothing can go wrong in here.
My scurrying little friend. Just a child? What are you doing running around, Vigrid? You're certainly not dressed in your Sunday best.
There we go. I'm not gonna... I got a secret weapon, but I'm not gonna use it just yet. There we go. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I nailed it. Come on, bitch. Don't fuck with me, I'm going crazy. Alright, progress. You just sit your ass up there, bitch. Oh, yeah. Super Saiyan Bayonetta. Holy shit, I've broken. I mean, come on, just look at it. There we go. Oh yeah. Take him down. Full swing. Boom. Take him down in grand style. All right. Let's see if we can end on a high note, even higher than this. I definitely need this. Oh yeah! How many bullets we got? Plenty. You know what? I'll take it. All right, as the holy city of Vigrid burns, looks like we've reached the end of chapter 3, and by far the best chapter so far. Believe it or not, I actually think I mentioned this earlier, but I think I bypassed the moment where I reached during the Xbox 360 days. So if that's the case, I literally have no collection of remembrance of what happens going forward. I knew certain things, but this is about as far as I made it. So whatever happens next is going to be fresh, and I cannot wait to check this out. This may be the spiciest chapter yet, so I can't wait to see what the rest of the game turns out to be. But I'm going to wrap it up here with a chapter per upload, so we're going to finish up here. So if you like this video, you know what to do. Give that thumbs up, comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. You know I can make you